Well, hi everybody, welcome to my channel. This is a third video of the Git tutorials. In this video, I'm going to show how to create the pull request for another developer's review our code, and how to merge the pull request in the different branches. So I'm going to start now. So basically, I'm going to use Pet Clinic project. So if you didn't watch my previous video, so Pet Clinic is a free open source project for educational purposes. So we can find this project in the official Spring website. So the link is in the description below. No, is if you are interested in working on this, or you can practice with your own projects. So basically what I'm going to do first is I have just one branch here, the main branch. So I'm going to create a new branch and then modify that new branch and create the pull request for merge the changes in that branch in the master branch. So first of all, I want to create a new branch. First, I want to check if I am in the correct branch. So I am in the master branch. So here I'm going to create a new branch. That is So and then what I'm going to do next is synchronize move to this branch. So as we can see here, we have the branch. So now we need to pull the changes, pull this branch in our external Git. So we need to use this command here. Okay, so now it's in the GitHub. So if I go into the GitHub here, we can see here we have the new branch, and then this button for create the pull request. We are able to create the pull request from here as well. So what I'm going to do is modify something here just for the review. So I'm going to modify this POM file here. So POM the version. Version 4. Okay. So now I'm going to add the changes in Git. Git commit. I'm going to modify another file as well, just for have more files for check here. So I'm going to modify this one. Okay, so we can add something here. Okay, so next is add this readme file again. So and then commits. Okay, so I forgot the flag here. Yeah, so and then so we need to push the code in our external repo. Okay, so now if I go to the repository, we can see here the branch change a few minutes ago. So we have compare and pull request here, so or we are able for Click here as well, so it's the same thing. So as we can see here, we have a problem with the merge. We can solve that later. So here we have the file change. So I change the POM file and the README file, and git show me the code, no? So the changes. So we change the number here in the version. So here we can define the title and the description about the changes, this pull request. Okay, so a small changes. So the good thing is this review. So for example, if we need to add a print screen or something in the some image in the description, we are able for drag and drop an image here. So for example, I don't know, so any image. So for example, so if I drag and drop, you can see the image here. So that is really useful if you want to show in a screen with the changes or something like that. So as we can see here, we have the reviewers. So in here, obviously I am not a member of a team, or I don't have any other developer associated with my account. So, but if we are working in the work environment, we have all the teams here for that as a reviewer, no? So not just only one person. So we can create the groups as well, and for the code review. And okay, so next one, we can create a draft pull request, or create a normal pull request. So if we create the draft pull request, so it's the same thing in theory. The difference is it's not effective. We are not able to merge the code directly. So and then if we pass the draft, so we are able for transform the draft in the normal pull request for merge the code. But it's a previous step, no? If we are not sure about the changes for the pull request. So if I click here, pull request, so as we can see, we have the description, and then what is the image in this case. And we have one conflict here. So that's really good for you. I'm going to show what's going on here. So if we click in resolve conflicts, so as we can see here, so it show me we have a conflict in the version with the main one. So what I'm going to do here is keep the changes in the branch for merge with the master. So mark as a resolve, commit merge. Okay, and then so that fixed the problem. So sometimes we have inconsistency with the master a branch or another branch we wanted to merge. So maybe a number is wrong, or a code and git tell you he can merge the code for his own, so we need to make some changes there, no? Well, so next step is if we ask people, so another developers, they are able for add the comments. In this case, so I'm going to add the comment as an author, but basically it's the same thing. So you are able for entering other people pull requests and add the comments here. So for example, okay, so we start the review. As we can see here, we have the comments. And well, so in here we are able for add the comments, approve the pull request with the comment if you wish, and request changes if we need to change something, no? See? In that case, I added the comments. So, well, obviously I am not a member of the team, no? But so we can define the policies for the pull request and for wait for the merge until we have all the approvals, no? So for the different members of the team, maybe the team lead or another members of the team. So and well, so I don't have a connection with Jenkins here, but if we have Jenkins, so we are able for commits automatically the build the code in this PR in Jenkins, and Jenkins let you know if you have any problem, no? So in this case, so I'm going to ignore my message, but say we can have a discussion here about the changes. And then if we click here in merge, so git ask for confirm, and we can add in more details here, so the comments. So as you can see, I merge this branch with the master branch. So now in the master branch, I will see this new version 2.4.4. So after the merge, we are able for remove the branch because we don't longer need it. So obviously we are able for reverse restore the branch if we make a mistake. So now I am going to I'm going to the master branch. So as we can see here, so basically I modified this one before. So we can see here the new version after our merge. And then, so if I click here, we have the details, no, of the changes. Well, and that is how the pull request works, no? So that is really useful when we want to do the review from our code from another developers, no? And well, so hope you like the video. So I'll see you in the next one. Thank you very much.